Hi guys, good evening. It's been a while na wala ko ka video, then wala ko ka live. It's because I've got fatigue naman. I've got an asthma attack na naman. So tired talaga guys, as in. So this time wala man ko gibuhat, and before I started to read this Bible, I prayed na already kanina. So give me wisdom to understand what's in the Word of God. Sa para masabtan ako ang sa akong ibasa. So today I'm going to share with you, and same thing, you can kaan ka nang magsabay na lang kasako to read this Bible. So let's start. A reading from the book of Numbers, verse 17, chapter 17 to 6. So, Aaron stops once. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to the people of Israel, and get from them staffs, one for each father's house, from all their chiefs, according to their father's houses, 12 staffs. 12 staffs. Write each man's name in his staff, and write Aaron's name on the staff of Levi. For there shall be one staff for the head of each father's house. Then you shall deposit them in the tent of meeting before the testimony, where I meet with you, and the staff of the man whom I choose shall sprout. Thus I will make to cease from me the grumblings of the people of Israel, which they grumble against you." Moses spoke to the people of Israel, and all their chiefs gave him staffs, one for each chief, according to their father's houses, 12 staffs. And the staff of Aaron was among their staffs, and Moses deposited the staffs before the Lord in the tent of the testimony. The next day, Moses went into the tent of the testimony, and behold, the staff of Aaron for the house of Levi had sprouted and put forth buds and produced blossoms, and it bore ripe almonds. Then Moses brought out all the staffs from before the Lord to all the people of Israel, and they looked, and each man took his staff. And the Lord said to Moses, "Put back the staff of Aaron before the testimony, to be kept as a sign for the rebels, that you may make an end of the grumblings against me, lest they die." Thus did Moses, as the Lord commanded him, so he did. And the people of Israel said to Moses, "Behold, we perish. We are undone. We are all undone. Everyone who comes near to the tabernacle of the Lord shall die. Are we all to perish?" Duties of priests and Levites. So the Lord said to Aaron, "You and your sons and your father's house with you shall bear iniquity connected with the sanctuary, and you and your sons with you shall bear iniquity connected with your priesthood, and with you bring your brothers also, the tribe of Levi, the tribe of your father, that they may join you and minister to you while you and your sons with you are before the tent of the testimony. They shall keep guard over you and over the whole tent, but shall not come near to the vessels of the sanctuary or to the altar, lest they and you die. They shall join you and keep you guard over the tent of meeting for all the service of the tent, and no outsider shall come near you. And you shall keep guard over the sanctuary, over the altar, that they may never again be wrath of the people of Israel. And behold, I have take your brothers, the Levites, from among the people of Israel." They are a gift to you, given to the Lord to do the service of the tent of meeting, and you and your sons with you shall guard your priesthood, where all the concerns the altar and that is within the veil, and you shall serve. I give you priesthood as a gift, and any outside your counselor shall be put to death. Then the Lord spoke to Aaron, Behold, I have given you charge of the contributions made to me, all the consecrated things of the people of Israel. I have given them to you as a portion, and to your sons as a perpetual due. This shall be yours of the most holy things. You serve on the fire. Every offering of theirs, every grain offering of theirs, and every sin offering of theirs, and every guilt offering of theirs, which you render to me, shall be most holy to you and to your sons. In a most holy place shall you eat it. Every meal may eat it. It is holy to you. This also is yours, a contribution of your gift, all the wave offerings of the people of Israel. I have given them to you, and to your sons and daughters with you, as a perpetual due. Everyone who is clean in your house may eat it. All the best of the oil, and all the best of the wine, and of the grain. The first fruits of what they give to the Lord, I give to you. The first ripe fruits of all that is in their land, which shall bring to the Lord, shall be yours. Everyone who is clean in your house may eat it. Every boated thing in the shell shall be yours. Everything that opens the womb of the all flesh, whether man or beast, which they offer to the Lord, shall be yours. Nevertheless, the firstborn of man you shall redeem, and the firstborn of unclean animals you shall redeem. And the redemption price is adamantly you shall redeem them. You shall fix at 5 shekels in silver, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, which is very 20 gerahs. But to the firstborn of a cow, or the firstborn of a sheep, or the firstborn of a goat, you shall not redeem. They are holy. You shall sprinkle their food on the altar, and shall burn their fat offering with a pleasing aroma to the Lord. But your flesh shall be yours, as the breast that is weaved, and as the right thigh as are yours. All the holy contributions that the people of Israel present to the Lord, I give to you, and to your sons and daughters with you, as a perpetual due. It is a covenant of salt forever before the Lord for you, and for your offspring with you. And the Lord said to Aaron, You shall have to inheritance in the land, neither shall you have any portion among them. I am your portion, and I will, and your inheritance among people of Israel. To the Levites I have given every title of Israel for an inheritance, in return for the service that they do, their service in the tent of meeting, so that the people of Israel do not come near the tent of meetings, lest they bear sin and die. But the Levites shall do the service of the tent of meeting, and they shall bear their injury. It shall be perpetual statute throughout your generations, and among the people of Israel they shall have the inheritance. For the tithe of the people of Israel, which they present as a contribution to the Lord, I have given to the Levites for inheritance. Therefore I have said of them that they shall have the inheritance among the people of Israel. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Moreover, you shall speak and say to the Levites, when you take from the people of Israel the tithe they have given you from them for inheritance, then you shall present a contribution from it to the Lord, a tithe of the tithe, and your contribution shall be counted to you as though it were the grain of the threshing floor, and as the fullness of the wine press. So you shall also present no contribution to the Lord from all your tithes, which you receive from the people of Israel. And from it you shall give the Lord contribution to Aaron the priest. Out of all the gifts to you, you shall present every contribution due to the Lord, from each best part is to be dedicated. Therefore you shall say to them, When you have offered from it the best of it, then the rest shall be counted to the Levites as produce of the threshing floor, and as produce of the winepress. And you may eat it in a place, you and your household, for it is your reward in return for your service in the tent of meeting. And you shall bear no sin by reason of it, when you have contributed the best of it. But you shall not profane the holy things of the people of Israel, lest you die. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye for now.